Welcome to all, myself, Professor Deshmukh is presenting the theory lectures based on V-engine. Before starting anything, you have to see what is the balancing here. So balancing is quite easier one, where there is a coincidence of the two points, that is first, center of gravity and that of your center of rotations. For a system to be in a complete balance, both force and coupled polygons should be closed in order to prevent the effect of centrifugal force. So if there is a single plane is there, that is called as what? That the mass is only in a single plane. Under that condition only the centrifugal forces are acting. If there is a the different planes are there, under that conditions centrifugal couples are acting on it. So what is EV engine? We have to consider the OA is operating with the two connecting rods, common crank we have to use. Let's see the figures. This is the figure shows that OA is a common crank having the two pistons with the two connecting rods with angle theta alpha and alpha from the X axis, that is horizontal axis, we can say that. B1 and B2 be the points which is on the pins, which is connected at the connecting rod and that of your pistons. So now again center of line of two strike are in a X axis. Okay. Theta be the angle moved by crank from its X axis. By the crank. So what is basic difference here? The line drawn from B1 to O, which makes angle theta, and B2 again makes angle alpha, okay, from the x-axis angle, that is theta. Primary force, that is the primary force of one along with the stroke OB1, that is m r omega square cos theta minus alpha. Primary force at the one, that is the x axis, m r omega square theta minus alpha cos theta. So primary force on 2, that is the along the line of stroke, that is OB2, that is m omega square cos theta plus alpha. Similar one, that is m r omega square cos theta plus alpha into cos alpha. This is the along the second, that is the x axis. The total primary forces, just make the combination of these two. M r omega square cos alpha in bracket cos theta minus alpha plus cos theta plus alpha. M r omega square cos alpha plus into 2 cos theta cos alpha twice m r omega square cos square alpha into cos theta. Total primary force along the line z axis, m r omega square in bracket cos theta minus alpha into sin theta cos theta plus alpha into sin theta. Resultant primary force, just make the twice m r omega square cos theta into cos alpha bracket square plus twice m r omega square sin square theta into sin theta twice m r omega square in bracket cos square theta into cos alpha plus sin square alpha into sin theta. So this is the resultant primary force will be at the angle beta with the x axis, that is given by tan beta is equal to sin square alpha into sin theta divided by cos square alpha into cos theta. If the 2 alpha is equal to 90 degree, the resultant force will be given to equal to twice m r omega square cos square 45 degree and cos theta sin square 45 degree sin square theta m r omega square tan beta sin square 45 degree sin theta divided by cos square 45 and cos theta into tan theta. For given value of alpha, the resulting force is maximum when cos square alpha, cos square theta, sin square theta, sin alpha is maximum. Derivative you have to take, that is d upon d theta, cos raised to 4 theta, cos square theta, sin raised to 4 theta, sin square theta. Alpha is not 0, that is resultant primary force, theta is equal to 0 determine the secondary force. MR omega square divided by n cos 2 in bracket theta minus alpha. Okay, secondary force, that is MR omega square, again same, that is cos 2 in bracket theta minus alpha into cos alpha. Secondary force of the two angle, two along the line of stroke, that is a O beta 2, that MR omega square 1 n cos theta plus alpha. M R omega square cos 2 upon theta plus alpha, that is cos alpha. That is equation number 5. The total forces acting along the z axis, that is twice M R omega square upon n sin theta, sin alpha, sin 2 theta. Okay, resultant primary forces. So this is all about the thing that is the, we are seen in the last, that is the secondary force, that is twice M R omega square theta tan beta sin theta, sin 2 theta upon sin theta cos 2 theta. So okay, and tan beta is equal to that infinity, while beta is equal to 90 degrees. This is the case where the force act along the z axis and harmonic force and the specific methods to be balanced. So again, one more simple case, that is the case where we are exist.